so nice being here.
Oh, so nice having you all here. It's so great. It's so family. 17 years ago, this first band. So, you know, it's like,
I can tell you know, we can just use the box.
Sure. Can't be sure.
We're not even
doing that. Oh, yeah. How are
you doing? Wow.
Okay, Tom, give him the story.
Good morning, Larry. Let the music do that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Wow, thank you for being here for this. It's a special night. 17 years ago, new band recorded their first album in the old atrium of the Whitecage. And the many records since. Most of these gentlemen have played for me at one concoction or another over the last 25 years. And Joe might have been the most.
I've been here a lot.
Yeah.
Lucky guy.
This was a lot. Anyway, again, thanks for being out and supporting this type of music and this type of thing. It does me a lot of good, and I hope it does you a lot of good, too. I have a lot of really great things planned for the next couple of months through June, so check out the website. I'm way behind in getting handbills and posters done, but the website's the most reliable source of accuracy in my world. So, again, it's great to have everyone out here hearing this stuff. Please welcome new band.
First record that Tom was talking about that we did, and it was recorded at the old Bob shop, was the one that sold the best. matter of fact, when we went back to the record label, which was a gentleman in Portugal, to get more, he said, "Sorry, I sold them all." He never reprinted, but I think that was probably our biggest seller. Would you agree?
Maybe.
Can't find them anymore.
Had a nice
you got one. You got one.
One from France with the croissants is sold out also.
So we have two sell. Man, check that out. We got two sellouts.
Depends who printed them.
Yeah. All right. So we're gonna start with something called "Read This." One, two.
Thank you.
quite a bit of a walkout at the beginning of the night. Says the trumpet player. The next piece we'd like to do is a dedication to the original trumpet player of this band, Roy Campbell, who passed away in 2014. We miss him dearly. And the tune is called One for Roy.
Thank you.
Composition of mine. It's entitled The Last of the Beboppers.
Thank you. can't do it with my thumb. Button this. I can't button it because of my thumb.
I got a damaged thumb. I can't button my own shirt.
And I'm happy to help.
All right, now I'm ready.
You sure can play.
Go ahead, Mark, tell him about this.
We're going to pray now. Pray for the water protectors. I think you all hip here, you've heard about the water protectors and what they were doing last winter and how they were brutalized by the government goons. But they're still taking the land away from the native Indians. And this time they want to put a pipeline underneath the Missouri River, which I think has already gone under since Trump came in. But they are fighting very hard for us.
It's already leaked, as a matter of fact.
Mm-hmm.
It's already leaked.
Oh, they do leak. Everyone leaks. Everyone has leaked. Everyone is expected to leak, and they don't care. And they're trying to protect their own water and ours, too. And I just like to do a little prayer for them. And we've been doing it since we've gone out in the last couple tours. We've been playing. I got this Native American flute from a guy named Wally Fort, who's a Native American, lives out in Arizona, and makes beautiful flutes. I broke off the fetish, they call this. There used to be a bird up here. But since I'm traveling so much, I keep breaking it off. But it doesn't affect the sound of the flute, so I leave it like it is. So this is the prayer for the water protectors.
Thank you.
Prayer for the water protector. Thank you.
entitled Minor Madness.
We'd like to continue with a piece of mine. And this is a train piece. Since I got interested in jazz, I was always very fond of Duke Ellington. He was one of my first inspirations, and I assume that's probably true for all of us. So in the 30s and the 40s, his band traveled by train most of the time, and so he actually wrote a lot of pieces, like train pieces, that resemble the sound of a train. I always found that really inspiring and exciting. So I wrote a series of train pieces, and this is one of them. The title is The Closer You Are, The Further It Gets. Thank you.
next tune is a composition of mine that was inspired by a tragic event. As you all well know, we have a problem with gun violence in this country. And there was a shooting in 2012 in a movie theater in Aurora, Colorado, where 12 people were killed and I think it was 50 others injured. And at the time, that one had a very strong emotional impact on me. And in working that out for myself, this tune came about. Unfortunately, since then, there have been many more and much worse mass shootings in this country. I hope we can find a resolution to this problem. But in the meantime, this is dedicated to the victims of that event, and it's entitled Dark Dawn in Aurora. Thank you.
Yeah, we are. We're gonna play.
Okay, let's
so
play
this next
place.
Piece is a thing dedicated to two friends that influenced it. One is Ornette Coleman. You know, at the near the end of Ornette's life, I got to go over to his house. A friend of mine had introduced me. So, you know, Ornette was the kind of guy to let people come over and hang out. Didn't matter who you were. So, I remember the first time I went over. I was so excited, my hero, I was gonna play with him, and I get there, I bring my bass in, and we sit around for quite a while, because he loved to talk, we drank a lot of root beer, and then finally he said, come on, let's play. So we go into the room, and we start playing. We're probably in there 45 minutes straight, maybe an hour. I'm loving every minute of it, and all of a sudden, Ornette disappears. My eyes were closed, and I looked around, and I realized, man, I'm all by myself.
And I think, Jesus, what do I do? And I think, I better not stop, because maybe he just went to the toilet or something. So I'm still playing, but I play for another 20 minutes just by myself, and he doesn't come back. And I think, well, maybe I better stop and check it out. So I stop, I go out into the kitchen, and man, he's there with this beautiful woman having lunch. And I thought, you know, the beautiful woman was his partner. You know, she comes over at a certain time for lunch, and Arnett just thought it was, you know, time for him to have lunch. But he didn't tell me, man. He would have left. I could still be in that room playing to this day if I hadn't stopped. Arnett would have left me in there for years. But anyways, that's my Arnett Coleman story. And so this is some of the ideas I stole from him for this. And the other part I stole from a French friend of mine named Christophe Rocher.
Play.
I'm
so we call it. Well, we were trying to decide if we stop or if we play one more.
Play one more.
One more.
While we're all here.
Yeah, we're all here. It's cold as hell outside. All right, so we'll play one more for you.
Thanks.
Wait, hell is cold?
Wait a minute. Worse than you thought.
Okay, so it's the last night, so put a real tempo up on us. Kick us. Kick
one
us, Mark.
Thank you.
It's Lou Grassi on the drums. Lou Grassi.
Joe Pond on the bass.
Thomas Heberer on the trumpet.
And the maestro, Mark Whitecage.
Mark Whitecage.
Thanks to Tom and Jen and all the people that work so hard here to keep the music happening. Thank you.
And we had some wonderful food at Robert and Donna's. Yes. We gotta say, man, that was something. We can't play like this without that kind of food, let me tell you.